Downloading Remits from Gateway into TRAKnet 3.0. First, you're going to come to your billing dashboard and click on the Gateway EDI icon. This will log you directly into your Gateway account. When you come into your Gateway account, you'll click on the new Remittance. From here, you will see your remittance that are available to download for your day or your date range. You can change your date range by selecting your calendar to print your remittance. You can either select all and view them in the Medicare style for printing, or individually and print them from there as well. I've already printed mine this morning and I'm ready to download. The easiest way is just to hit my select all, and as you can see, that's put a check mark in all of my boxes. That is going to download all of these remits that are available for download, and by selecting the download button here, these will now be available to load into my TRAKnet 3.0. As you can see in my TRAKnet 3.0, I am still on my claims tab on my billing dashboard, and my green receive is highlighted. I'm going to click receive, and what that will do is download those remits from Gateway that we just selected. As you can see, it tells me my remits have been processed. Once I click OK, I'm going to change for today's date range because I just want to see today's that we downloaded. And there are my remits that I downloaded from Gateway. So again, I came into my billing dashboard, I went to my claims, I went out to my Gateway EDI and selected them for download, came in, selected receive, and these are the ones that we just received. You'll notice here that I have one that may not be applying everything across the board, so I do get a notice that there's something else that I need to look at there. Let's take a quick look at how our remits look in the download. By double-clicking on my remit, you can see there's all of my payments. Everything looks like it has applied correctly, as I have zero balances and nothing left to be applied. So I'm going to close that one. I'm going to come into my Medicare, and for my PQRS, we have all those penny charges. I want to get rid of those. So I'm going to click my Enable Auto Calc and go and put zeros in those lines. And I want you to notice as I did those, the red outline that came around the saved. I have to click Save in order for them to stay. If I don't click Save, they will go back to a penny. If they're green, that means that patient did not have a secondary on file for that claim to go to, so it's already gone to patient responsibility. You'll also notice I can add comments to each line if I needed to. And I'll continue that on down my EOB, make sure I get rid of all of those penny charges. As you can see, I have quite a few to do. This one, there was no payment, which I believe it went to a deductible. And this one is, I know, a secondary payment, and you can see how that all applied correctly. Now let's take a look at that one that had a remaining balance. So I'm going to come in here, and I want you to notice I have a lot of negative numbers here because this is actually a secondary payment. And a lot of times when secondary payments come through, they've put that adjustment on there again. So you can see that's how we've ended up with that negative. I want to get rid of those. So I'm just going to highlight the amount and delete. And I'm going to go right down my line. I do it this way. You can do them one at a time. And again, we have that red circle around the save. And it's going to tell me that I have a balance greater than what's owed because we're removing that adjustment. And I know that, so I'm going to get a couple of those as we move down this list. And now you can see everything's turned to black. It's a zero balance. There's nothing remaining. And let's take a look at that unapplied payment for who that was for. We see what patient that was for, so I can come back here and check who that is for and find their claims. And nothing's coming up, so what I want to do is uncheck these two, the balance only and this payer only button, to see if maybe I can get that claim to come up. And there it is. So now we can apply that amount for that EOB and add it. And now I've applied that payment that was outstanding. So now when I close this, we can see that everything has been applied. So that's how our remits work from downloading. And you'll notice it says right up here, remits processed. So these are the ones that we downloaded. Once I've downloaded them, the next thing I want to do is come into claims pending because I want to send out those secondary claims. I can filter out by my secondaries, which is what I want to do. And you'll notice some of these were marked electronically and we need to change that. So I can just highlight those couple and change them permanently by coming to my change output to none. And it tells me I'm going to change them permanently, and that's exactly what I want to do. Now all of those are just ready to flip over to secondary responsibility. So I'm just going to select my all and send those out. So that's how I remit download from beginning to end through some adjustments as well as some unapplied and sending out the secondaries that correlate with those as well.